it will not allow to touch this wire to the body. So we can say we have to test the insulation. Set multimeter to ohms or continuity. Connect one lead to the commutator, second lead to the body. So it have a short winding. Friends, in this video we will discuss how we can test armature of a DC generator, DC motor. Armature keeps rotating. It is mechanically coupled to take a drive, to give a drive. If it is generator, it will take mechanical rotation, mechanical drive. And if it is a motor, it will give mechanical out in the form of rotation. From here to here, it is called armature. Armature shaft. Then we have bearing at the both ends. It is called commutator block. Commutator, it have a spring loaded carbon brushes in the both side. How it will work? Any motor, it have a stator winding, then it have carbon brushes, then it have a rotor here that is called armature, then we have stator winding, and this is the output, positive and negative. We apply DC voltage and it will cause to flow a current in stator, then armature, second stator, and positive end. If it is a DC generator, then the winding have separate excitation and we take output from these brushes, from this commutator. So construction is same. There is a slight difference between generator and motor for excitation, and here it is. In the DC motor, the current will pass in series. So this armature will generate magnetic pole north south, and we have magnetic poles here that is in the winding. So in that case it will move. Some motors have permanent magnet. We apply a positive and negative voltage to the brushes. In that case, it will generate magnetic field and it will rotate. There are different techniques which are used. Commutator block, it makes physical connection to pass the current through winding. If you see commutator block, it have segments. Every segment is separated, it is insulated from the second. It have insulation between two segments, this and this. Its construction is, we have this winding, one carbon brush is here, one carbon brush is here, so it will cause to flow the current in the winding, in this winding. So it will make a magnetic field. So this magnetic field will cause to move this armature, because here we have north and south poles. So this magnetic field will cause to move this armature. Opposite poles will attract to each other and similar pole will repel to each other. So it will cause to move. It have to pass the current from this winding to the second end. That is 180 degree opposite. If one segment is here, the second segment should appear in the opposite side. We have connection from this point. Commutator block, armature stack. Armature stack, it have winding. This winding will start from one segment and it will reach to the other segment. And it will pass through this slot. It is called armature stack slot. Through this slot, between each slot, that is called stack tooth. It is called stack tooth. And each stack tooth, it have a U-shape. We have a U-shape cut, and each cut is separated with the insulation paper. And in this U-block, we have winding wire, which is connected to segment here. From one segment, it will move here through this slot, and it will come out. And here we have also a slot. So then it will connect to the opposite segment. So this insulation paper provides insulation and it will not allow to touch this wire to the body. So we can say we have to test the insulation. Set multimeter to ohms or continuity, and we can check this insulation. Connect one lead to the commutator, second lead to the body armature shaft. So it have a short winding. In that case, if we apply power, the current will pass from the stator. When it will reach in the armature, after that it will discharge in the body. So it will not allow to complete the circuit, so this motor will not move, this generator will not generate voltage. Why? Because our electrical power is discharging here in the body. So it is first test. Any armature which have this test fail, it have a short circuit with the chassis, with the ground, that will not work. This is good condition. So this armature have good condition. It is not a short circuit. This armature short circuit, and this armature short circuit. So it is failed. So we can say the ground test, that is failed. So it must be insulated from the body. As we have this armature, so it should open. Now this armature is bad. What is the reason for this damage? Sometimes this bearing is damaged. When it is damaged, it will make a mechanical touch with the stator winding, because the stator poles are very close to each other. When it will touch to the stator, that is a piece of iron core, in that case it will make a friction and it will become overheat, it will damage. Now the second test. One winding from one pole to the second pole, it is coming here. It will cause to flow current, it will rotate. When it will rotate, the second commutator ring will come in front of brushes. So in that case, we have winding like this. So if we see from this end, this winding is starting from here and it is reaching here. So that means we should have continuity from this point to this point. First we have to check this connection. I opened this winding to make test for 180 degree, that is winding test. Now our this winding which I open, this end, it have just only the connection with opposite ring, opposite commutator block. As we discussed, it is reaching to the opposite side commutator segment. So from this point it is reaching here in this segment. So it means we must have connection from this point to this point. The second point which I removed from this end, it will reach to the next segment here, that is here. I disconnected this end, so we will take continuity from this end, and the second point of this winding will reach to the next segment. This is the second end and it is reaching to the next ring, which is the damaged one. Next to that it will reach here. Now our winding sequence, before this it was making connection between these carbon, these segments, then it will move to these. So we must have connection between these two segments. So in that case our winding will reach here. when it will move, it will make connection to this, and this one will make connection to the next, and it will make connection, and from this point it will make connection. So every segment it have connection in this way. If we look between this point, it have a winding, it have a connection from this side, and it have a connection from the complete series set. Then we discussed here. So we have to test this connection. The first test that was at 180 degree. So we have to move one by one. We have to put multimeter for the first test. Now rotate to the second ring, third ring, fourth ring, and we have to rotate it, and we have to verify every point. Now we have to check these two points, each segment, from this segment. Then we have to test every two points, this, then, if it is open, if we don't have a connection, in that case it will give high resistance, or it have, if it have a bad connection, it will give high resistance. We can verify from these two points, it is giving some 1 ohm, 2 ohm resistance, but it is giving high resistance. Why? Because it have bad soldering, bad connection here. Here we have 800 ohms are like that. Here we have 150 ohms resistance. So here we have short circuit. Why? Because the commutator segment is touched to each other. Because from this point it have a short circuit to each other. You can see it is giving 700, 800 ohms. Why? Because this winding have bad connection. Due to overheat, when the carbon brushes are loose, they will generate a heat here. So that heat can make a dry soldering between these connections. So in that case, we will have a high resistance. So this segment is open. Ideally, there should be no resistance, because it is using double wire for winding for high current. It have resistance in micro ohms. Ideally it should have no resistance or very low resistance. We can see it is open. When it is open, that means there is a disconnection. Either the winding is damaged, winding has, maybe the winding have open, or it have disconnection from any point. So if this test is fail, our armature will bad. In this video we discuss three tests. First test, that is short test with ground. So ground test should open. Then we have to test 180 degree opposite segment. It should give indication. We have to move every winding, should give resistance. Then we have to check each segment to each other. And all resistance should be similar. If some segments are giving high resistance, That means that segment have bad connection. Here we have some high resistance. So the resistance in these segments is not allowed. I hope so this video is informative. If it is informative, give a thumb up. If you have any question, let me know in the comment box. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.